Hey, this is Nick Cornelius, the real hustler, and we will be sitting here today talking about the movie The Heat.
Sir, I don't understand. I've closed more cases than any agent here.
You are a solid agent, but you're not a team player. None of the other agents like you. Wait for my three count.
One, two. Unbelievable.
You got a situation in Boston. I'm sending you up.
FBI, we recently got intel that you brought in a dealer, Terrell Rojas.
Hey, look who's here!
Detective Mueller's in the back room lunch here.
I'm sure he won't mind.
Well, he's a she.
Oh, it's on! She's crazy!
Puffy, enjoy Peter. Dallas, how's it going?
Good, how are you?
We're great. We're great.
Thank you.
Well, welcome back to Detroit for me.
Yeah.
I'm a native.
This is a homecoming for you.
Oh, amen to that.
Yeah.
Happy to be here.
Look at this guy. This guy is sharp.
See how he's stepping up?
I read somewhere that this guy won Best Dressed.
I am.
2012?
Yes, Esquire magazine did call me the best dressed man in Hollywood.
Now you see why. Now, this is your second movie with Melissa McCarthy.
Mm-hmm.
So you guys got a little chemistry. How is it working with her?
Oh, she's the greatest. I mean, she's really like one of my comedy heroes. And, you know, we were neighbors. She lives in my neighborhood, and we've just become really good friends ever since Bridesmaids. And it's just, I'm always looking for opportunities to work with her. And, you know, her energy is just infectious on the set. And she's, you know, she's such a home run all the time. Like, you just kind of, I'm always amazed when we're shooting, like, wow, where'd that line come from? Okay, that joke, I didn't expect that, and that's hilarious. So she makes my job easy, is basically what it is. I just sit there and try not to laugh and ruin the take. Yes.
Is it true that Katie, the writer of the film, thought mm-hmm. she was being pranked when you were interested in doing the movie?
She shouldn't feel that way, because she's one of the most talented writers I've ever met in my life.
And is it true that you're going to be working with her again on her next movie?
Yeah, well, she's writing, not only, well, she's currently writing a sequel to this, just in case it does well. Don't want to jinx it. Just so we have it. And then she's writing another movie, an original idea that she pitched about a mother and daughter going on a very crazy vacation.
And that's your involvement?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay. Oh, yeah. If I could do nothing but work with anything Katie has written, I would be a very happy man. Mm-hmm. She's the best. Yeah.
Was there anything in particular about the script that drew you to it?
You know what? The minute I opened the envelope, and it was originally called The Untitled Female Buddy Cop Comedy, I was like, I'm in.
Yeah.
First of all, you go like, these haven't been around. I want to do this. I've always wanted to do an action comedy. You know, but then you go like, I hope the script's good. Because a lot of times you get them, they're terrible. And then I'm reading the script on an airplane, I'm laughing out loud. So the minute I landed, it's like, I want to do this.
Yeah.
Send it to Melissa immediately. I want her to read it. Because Sandra was already interested in doing it. Mm. And then it all came together.
Question for Joey. You have done some acting over the years or whatever. Mm-hmm. How did you come to get involved in this?
Well, I think two of the I play one of the crazy Mullins family characters. So two of those characters, Jamie Dembo and Jessica Chaffin, great Boston actors and friends of Paul already. But we did this spoof of Mad Men. We called it Mad Men for Massachusetts Men.
filthy
parody. It was on Funny or Die, and you know, you never know in this business. Like, you could do all this, you know, bunch of guest spots on TV shows and getting your thing, and you know, letting people know you're acting, and then just one little thing that leads to. I got more heat off of, no pun intended, heat off of that.
Nice plug.
And then and that was a couple of years ago, but. Also, I think those guys probably put in a good word for me and Boston actors sticking together.
Well, but I will tell you, I saw that video. Yeah. I was like, who is that? Joey McIntyre? He's hilarious.
Yeah, yeah.
And that was it. Literally, it was done. Yeah. It was a done deal. He was in the movie.
After the success of Bridesmaids, I wanted to ask you, do you feel any kind of added pressure with this film, The Heat, in terms of how people receive it?
Yeah, you know, you always do. When you have a movie that does really well, you're always afraid to follow it up with something that doesn't do as well. But at the same time, I'm really confident about this one because, first of all, you know, the amazing cast that we have and the amazing writing on the, you know, it all just came together well. But also, when I'm putting a movie together very early in the process of editing, I'll start doing test screenings for audiences, off-the-street audiences, and we do about 10 test screenings over the course of months that we're editing. So I know by the time we're done that it works in general, so it's nice. So I know at least people will all have a good time when they go, but who knows, you know, just hope they show up to the theater. But I think with Sandra and Melissa, I think, you know, that people do love them, I mean, rightfully so. So we'll see. Please come out. Please come out.
To piggyback on that question, were you worried to make it another female buddy comedy?
No. I if I make movies only with funny women the rest of my life, I'll be very, very happy. As long as Joey is in there at some point. But no, I love working with strong, funny women. I think they haven't gotten their due in comedy for a long time, and so I would like to write the record over and over again, because I really want to get to a point where it's not about women or men in a movie. It's just about funny people in a movie, and just break down the gender barrier.
I can't hold you.
All right, let's pull him up. Come on.
No, wait. I'm not kidding anymore. Really, I can't lift him up.
He's all right, right? The metal car broke his fall. That was pretty awesome.
You are killing us out there. You don't fit in.
I am a federal agent.
What are those?
They're Spanx. They just hold everything together.
Why? What's gonna